All right, Shalom, this is Karak Karak. First and foremost, want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Hashem Yahushak, the bonds to the elder apostle, the great millstone that rule well, and greetings and barakatha to all you sincere brothers throughout the four corners of the earth that are pushing the unadulterated truth and all meekness and sincerity to the masses to help set up the elect. And, you know, just looking at, you know, the times we're living in, which are the last seconds, 2 minutes left on the doomsday clock. And understanding, you know, why the Spirit had apostles to heart, you know, call this the year triple D's, man. You know, it's self-explanatory, death, destruction, and diligence. And the most important part of that is being diligent, because the death and destruction is coming. But the real question is, are you being diligent, you know? And what's the reason why? Because death and destruction is coming, you know? So you might ought to want to be diligent. Why? Because that's what will help you save your life, you know, through the Spirit and power you have by Shem Yahushua, which is by election, you know, Lord willing. But we have to do our part, man, you know. And, you know, being diligent doesn't necessarily mean putting up 100 videos a day. You know, it just being doing what's in your spirit, you know, and asking the Lord to impart into you the spirit to do more than what you feel comfortable with, you know. Why? Because we've all sinned and come falling short of the glory, you know, and we need to seek the Most High 10 times more. And, you know, and basically it boils down to your understanding of what's coming, you know. You have to wholeheartedly believe that the Most High's gonna fuck this place up, man. And if you ain't right, you're not gonna make it out of here, you know. That's why I say the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. So you gotta fear him, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, you have to wholeheartedly believe that he's going to do what he said he's going to do in these scriptures, you know. And that's why the scriptures say wisdom is the chief thing, you know. But with all our getting, get understanding and know that, look, you know, the Most High is a man that he shall not lie, you know. And if you do your part according to these scriptures, he has to deliver you. He has to, you know. So you know, you got to make it your duty to be importunate, to bother him, you know, to be diligent. That's why the scriptures say, make your calling of election sure. How do you do that? By being diligent, man. Just doing the work, man, following the, you know, the guidelines that the apostles set up, you know, and that bring me to, you know, what I wanted to get, the scriptures I wanted to bring out, because the Most High, you know, what he said is what he meant. He meant he's going to destroy this place, and he's going to destroy 2/3 of our people, but he also said he's going to deliver 1/3 of our people. A remnant, you know, and that's what we banking on, man. Because what else you banking on? You're not gonna carnally do anything to make it out of here, you know. So we have to wholeheartedly bank on and have faith, full faith, and be full hearted that, you know, if I keep doing what I'm doing and I do it to the end, he's gonna save me. And you know, the brothers that's sincere about this and that pushing this word and being diligent, they wholeheartedly believe it. Because if not, they wouldn't do it. And that's what it boils down to. If you're not being diligent, you're not pushing this word, and you're not doing, you know, to the best of your ability, you know, sometimes you get down in the spirit, but like the apostles always say, ask the Lord to give you some more fire, you know. I have to fight with that, you know. I tell him, give me some more spirit, Lord. Help, you know, help me to stay on fire, you know, because that's a demon too, you know, that sloth demon, you know. So your brothers constantly fight that, but ask the Lord, you know, be importunate. He would do it. He gave you this knowledge and understanding to be in his faith. So he'll give you more knowledge and understanding and more fire, you know, to push this word, you know. So this is Galatians chapter 6. Galatians chapter 6, verse 7. It says, be not deceived, the Most High is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Right. So, of course, if you sowing wickedness, Most High going to fuck you up, you know. But if you sow righteousness and you pushing this word, you know what I'm saying? You're going out diligently, week in and week out. You're fellowshipping, you're kicking with your brothers. You're showing charity, which covers a multitude of sins. You know, you're studying, keeping your head in the scriptures, having a balance. You know, you're gonna reap righteousness, man, which is salvation. You know, read that again. It says, be not deceived, the Most High is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Verse 8. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, right? If you're trying to get money, you know, get women, you know, things that appeal to the flesh, you know, because what we're doing doesn't appeal to the flesh, you know. we don't get lineups and, you know, and get tattoos and all that. You know, some brothers have tattoos, but we don't go out and get that shit. That's sowing to the flesh, you know. We're trying to get Fortune 500 jobs, you know, so we can get a lot of money and have goodies for these fucking women. Because at the end of the day, that's not profitable, you know. And the scriptures say that we're unprofitable servants. To who? Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. And to the elect. We're doing this so the elect can be sealed up, so the nation of Yahshua Allah can be saved. Plain and simple, you know. So that's one reason you don't, you know, you don't sow to the flesh, man. Because it's, hey, the scriptures say the flesh profiteth nothing but little, you know. The spirit quickeneth. So it says, verse 8, for he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption, but he that soweth to the spirit shall of the spirit reap life everlasting. And what's the spirit? These scriptures. So if you, you know, if you sow to the spirit, meaning staying in these scriptures, man, and you know, and just following the blueprint that was set up by Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai, and the elder apostles, man, you know, and they're pushing this unadulterated truth. Just follow the guidelines. Really simple. It's plain to those, you know, that have that had the ear, the spiritual ear, man, to hear this, you know. It's not hard, and if it's hard, it may not be for you, man. But it, the hard aspect of it is you know, standing in faith and doing what you got to do. But if you're doing what you got to do, it's not hard. That's why it's a righteous balance. It's hard, but it's not, you know. Okay. So yeah, basically, man, you know, if you reap up, you sow of the spirit, which is the scriptures, you're gonna reap spirit, which is life everlasting, which is salvation. You know, not all of Israel shall be saved, but there's going to be a first resurrection, you know, and that's what we're doing this for, man. That's what brothers got to understand. We're doing this so we don't be destroyed, man. If you can't understand that, this is not for you, man. You're in the wrong business. I am terrified of the King of Terrors, man. You know, he hasn't given us the spirit of fear. That's, you know, carnal things that can happen carnally. You know what I'm saying? We are afraid and fear the Heavenly Father and His Son, man. So that alone should push you to do what you have to do in this thing, man. And the reason why, because He's not slack concerning His promise. Whatever you sow, you're going to reap. So if you're reaping righteousness, you're being diligent, you're showing charity, you're just trying, you know, you're doing what the scriptures say to do, He got to save you, man. He has to. Okay? So from there, I'm going to go to 1 Corinthians. This 1 Corinthians 15 and 1. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you. This is Paul speaking. Which also you have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved. Salakia. Let me read that again. By which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. Right, and that's what it boils down to, man. If you keep this thing, the things that has been preached to us, and through these scriptures, through your Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah, through your elders, and through your understanding, you know, which has to coincide with the commonwealth of Yahshua, you know, if you have that understanding and you keep that, look, you're going to be saved, man. You see? And Paul says it plain, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. And that, and we finding that to be true with a lot of brothers, man. They believe this thing in vain. It's all there's something to do. You know, initially, they, you know, they were terrified, or fake being terrified, because I don't see how you could be terrified and not be terrified unless the spirit just ain't dealing with you, you know. But they say, yeah, unless they have believed in vain. Meaning you don't really believe the Heavenly Father coming back soon, and you're going to destroy two-thirds of these people, and you're going to destroy those that you know, that are not a part of the elect, man. So our goal is to try to strive for the masteries, you know, to strive to be part of the election, man. Even though it's a gift, you know, and it has to be given to you, you know, and it's been predestinated since the foundation of the earth. But hey, that. You know, you don't wonder about things that's above your knowledge, who the Most High chose and who He didn't chose. If your calling is to do His word, you have to be diligent about it. Why? Because like Paul said, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. It's plain, man. And that's basically what the scripture is. Keep the law, statutes, commandments. Do what you're supposed to do, which is not grievous. Which is not grievous, you know. Do that to the end, and you will be saved. Because that's what this all boils down to. The climax, which is Yahweh Shema Yahusha coming back to destroy wickedness from off the planet, man. And like we read in Galatians, if you're wicked, you're going to be destroyed, you know. But if you're righteous, you will be saved. That's a promise. And it goes both ways. Okay. This is, let's go to Job. Let's go to Job chapter 4. Job chapter 4, verse 6. Is not this thy fear, thy confidence, thy hope, and the uprightness of thy ways? Verse 7. Remember, I pray thee, whoever perished being innocent, or where were the righteous cut off?
Right.
So, and like that said, that's both sides of the spectrum scripture, you know? Where were the innocent, Salaki? It says, remember, I pray thee, whoever perished being innocent? Nobody. And that's rhetorical, but the answer to that is nobody ever perished being innocent. And then it also goes to say, where were the righteous ever cut off? You know, they may have passed on. They may have slept, you know, or given rest from their weariness. But being cut off means in the time of the flood, those eight people that were saved, Salaki, those eight people that were saved were the righteous. Were they cut off? No, they were saved. But everybody else that died was not innocent. They perished. And that's the reality to it, man. If you're sowing righteousness, you're going to make it. You're going to make it out of here, man. And what's being cut off? Disease, plagues, pestilence, the violence, the sedition amongst men, you know. And eventually the nuclear fire and the chariots, man. Destruction from the chariots. That's what's going to cut people off, man. You know, that's the second death. And that's what we're trying to avoid. And if you do, because this Bible, it's about lamentation, mourning, and woe. But within it is the guidebook to righteousness, how to walk, you know, and to strive for perfection, you know, as a righteous man. And it's already written, man. All you got to do is read and understand, man, and comprehend and apply it. That's all you have to do. And that's what predicates righteousness, plain and simple. And that's, you know, that's that faith and that's hope, that if I continue to walk this righteous walk, I'm not going to be cut off. And that's what I'm in it for. I don't want to be cut off. And that's what it boils down to. It's either you don't want to be cut off or you do want to be cut off. I don't know if I want to be cut or no. It's say make your call of election sure. And there's no gray area and there's no in between. You either want to be cut off or you don't. And how do you prove whether you want to be cut off or not? It's by your actions. It's by your walk. You know, this is all about what you do. That's why the scriptures say, be ye a doer of the word, not a hearer only. You know, so that's what it boils down to. Because if you're not being diligent, you're not doing what you want to do, you want to be cut off. Plain and simple. It's just that a lot of guys don't have the balls enough to say it. But as for the men that are striving to be saved, we don't want to be cut off. And we're going to do what we got to do, you know, Lord willing. Okay? So, last scripture I'm going to get here is Jeremiah. This is Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 11. And it reads, Yahweh Bashim Yahusha said, verily, it shall be well with thy remnant. You know what I'm saying? You see, that's all about the remnant at the end of the day. That's what it boils down to, that remnant. It says, Yahweh Bashim Yahusha said, verily, it shall be well with thy remnant. Verily, I will cause the enemy to entreat thee well in the time of evil and in the time of affliction. So, because we already know, the scripture tells us the devil, in our Revelation 12, chapter 12, verse, the devil has come down with great wrath, knowing that he had but a short time. And why? And it stems all the way back to in the garden, all the way back to Cain and Abel, all the way back to Jacob and Esau. The enmity that was set between Jacob and Esau, which are the major two players in this movie. But the Most High said here, he's going to cause an enemy. Let me read again. The Lord said, verily, it shall be well with thy remnant. Verily, I will cause the enemy to entreat thee well in the time of evil and in the time of affliction, which is very shortly to come, Jacob's trouble. But the Most High said he's going to cause the enemy to entreat us well. And you know, brothers that go out on the highways and hedging, we see it. We see it. You know, the police. It's like we're invisible to them. We can talk to them any kind of way. You know, not saying brothers, you know, go out there and do that. But you see it. Examples of, the angel of the Lord encamp around about them that fear the Lord. We see it. And this is the Heavenly Father we're talking about. He has the power to control. He controls everything, you know. So he's saying in a time of trouble, he's going to cause our enemies to entreat us. And that's what you're going to need, because if not, you're going to be destroyed, you know. So like I say, it all boils down to, what are you doing this for? Are you want to be heard? You want to be seen? You're doing it for maliciousness? You don't know why you're doing it? You're doing it for entertainment? It's just something to do? You don't have an understanding. You don't understand the power that controls the universe, and that he's a king of terrors. And he is extremely, extremely angry with the inhabitants of the earth. So he's coming back to judge righteously and give recompense according to thy works. So if you're wicked, you're going to die. Righteous, you're going to be saved. And that is a promise. And that's the reason we do it. I'm going to look up this word real quick. Entreat. Second, bear with me. Put that word entreat, and it says it's paga, which is mean to meet, light upon, join, to meet, to encounter, fail upon. To encounter, entreat of, request, to strike, touch, to cause, to light upon, to cause, to entreat, to make entreaty, interpose, to make attack, to reach the mark. So they kind of go up here. But, you know, it says entreat thee well, you know. So to come upon thee in all wellness, you know, to help us, you know. And that's what we're banking on. And it also says that in Job, you know, that if I'm not mistaken, that the riches of the wealthy are set up for the righteous, you know? So like I say, that's what we do it for, man. And brothers got to understand that. And I read in Galatians, he's not slack concerning his promise. If you're walking righteously, he's going to deliver you, you know? So with that, I'm going to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Shem Yahushua. And Rakathat Tal Yahakim, pushing his truth and meekness and sincerity. With that, Shalom.